Phoenix Deer Valley Airport with more than 25,000 hours of total flight time. And in the slot position is Lieutenant Colonel retired Greg Slick at Gear A, United States Air Force and United States Army. Flew UH-1 Hueys and the F-15 during a 20-year active duty service for the Army and the Air Force, over 23,000 flight hours. The Nanchang CJ-6A is a two-seat basic pilot trainer for the China's People's Liberation Army Air Force, the PLAAF. Still in use today, it was designed to build because it is very, very rugged. It is relatively inexpensive to own and operate, and it's very easy to maintain. So they are very, very popular. You saw them take off in the fingertip formation. Number four has moved into the slot position to form the diamond pass. So their first pass here will be the diamond formation. Number four in the slot, the planes are flying with a 3-foot wingtip clearance, passing show center at about 150 knots, a little about 250 feet altitude. There's a beautiful, nice diamond formation flown by the Desert Rats, the Nanchang CJ-6. Set up in their arrowhead formation now as they come over your left shoulder to show center for their second pass. There's the arrowhead formation. Tribute to the state of Arizona, celebrating, of course, this year 100 years of statehood. And you're participating in the Davis-Monthan Thunder and Lightning over Arizona 2012 Air Show. We'll be flying all throughout the day. They come in the entrail formation. Watch the 2x2 split now. As they do so, each wingman will fly strictly off his lead. Lead responsible for all maneuvering and planning for the formation. In the entrail formation, there goes 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 into the break there as they set up for this opposing 2x2 pass. Plane setting up now from the left and from the right at 150 knots. Closing speed of about 300 knots. Passing in close separation right at show center in their opposing pass, and then watch for the quick rejoin. Formation taught to all fledgling pilots, whether it be Air Force or Navy, Army. Even the helicopters learn the formation flight. All right, in from the left, in from the right, the 2x2 opposing pass by our Desert Rats. Ready, ready, and break. Now watch for the rejoin. Join up in the echelon formation. As they will pitch out, now you can see heading one, towards one another, but now watch and you'll see 1 and 2 as they lead off, and then 3 and 4 will join up on 1 and 2. Echelon is stacked down and behind, stacked down and either to the right or to the left from the airplane in front of you. You can be either echelon right or echelon left. In this particular maneuver where they'll be pitching out, they will be in echelon right formation, so they can pitch out to the left in the classic military 360 overhead approach. Lining up on the runway heading, flying overhead, and then executing a descending 360 degree circling turn to line themselves back up on the runway and land, hence the 360 overhead approach. Now settling down at about 250 feet altitude as they approach show center, they'll pitch with 2 second pacing in between, climbing to about 800 feet in the pitch out. And then they'll be making one final pass and an arcing pass back northbound as they head for home at Phoenix Deer Valley Airport. Echelon right formation now by the Desert Rats. There goes the pitch out by the Desert Rats. Incidentally, at 12 noon, that's about 20 minutes now, in a hangar right behind us here, they're going to be showing you an A-10 Thunderbolt 2 load simulation, how they load up the aircraft with weapons. So that'll be happening at 12 noon in a hangar behind us here. Here come the Desert Rats now in their final flyby. In the lead, Lieutenant Colonel retired Mike Beef Carter. In the number 2, Nanchang CJ-6. Colonel retired Mike Spanky Lynch. Number 3, Delta Airlines Captain Pat Cato Geary. And the fourth and final aircraft, Lieutenant Colonel retired Greg Slick Aguirre. Ladies and gentlemen, the Desert Rats from Phoenix. Good job.